Get fast, reliable internet for any budget. Now qualifying customers can get Xfinity internet free through the Affordable Connectivity Program. That's right, free high-speed internet from Xfinity. And internet essentials customers can get equipment included at no extra cost. Get started today.
We change our minds every day. About a million things a day. This is no different. You can't be afraid to be wrong. You can't be afraid to say, you know what? I'm just going to rethink this thing. People are not dying getting the vaccine. I better rethink this thing. I'm going to go call my doctor and have a discussion one more time. It is okay to change your mind.
Want your boss to put some real action behind the rhetoric when they talk about making your workplace more inclusive? Find out how to hold their feet to the fire and demand diversity on the Diversity Dude podcast.
Hello there, and welcome to the Diversity Dude podcast. I'm your host, Lambris Fisher, marriage and family therapist, author, and national speaker on the topic of multicultural awareness and diversity. Whether it be through one of my efforts as a marriage and family therapist or my efforts as an author or a national speaker on the topic of multicultural awareness and diversity, my personal mission is still the same, to do my part to improve the world one strengthened relationship at a time, which is why I appreciate the opportunity to share with you on this podcast and with some encouraging perspectives and practical strategies to help reduce cultural divides and ultimately strengthen cross-cultural relationships, both professionally and personally. Now, I want to begin today by asking you this question. What comes to mind when you hear the words diversity, equity, and inclusion? For some of you, those words bring to mind your company or organization's policy and procedure manual, or your HR, your human resources representative, telling you all things you can't say and implying that there are more things you can't say. And even if you accidentally say them, you'll be fired. Or for some, the diversity words, those type of language, remind you of all the celebrities and politicians that have been canceled because they weren't woke enough to meet society's growing expectations or standards. Now, for others, diversity is the beginning of a personal or professional conversation that always turns negative and pretty quickly, with someone always being angry or offended by what someone else says or does, maybe being accused of feeling or thinking negative things, or of people feeling offended by what someone thinks they said or thinks about them and feeling offended that they don't know more. See, as a result of all these type of experiences, conversations regarding multicultural awareness and diversity, equity, and inclusion are often avoided. Unfortunately, while it's understandable to avoid a conversation in order to not contribute to making it worse, this practice also results in removing yourself from being a part of the opportunity to make things better. That's where I'd like to help. See, over the years in my professional efforts as a marriage and family therapist, I've had the chance to help others overcome personal and relational struggles. I've also gained a very good understanding of not only the many similarities and differences there are between people, but also the many cultural misunderstandings that can hinder healthy interactions, either through unintentional cultural offenses or the avoidance of important issues altogether. Fortunately, many people admit that they don't feel comfortable addressing cultural issues in the workplace or at home. And this makes sense. That's why I'm excited for the potential of this podcast, the Diversity Dude podcast. See, I want this podcast to become a safe place where you can look forward to receiving encouraging and practical perspectives and strategies that can help you communicate more confidently with individuals from various backgrounds. Now, this includes differences not only in race and ethnicity, but also gender, gender identity, age, religion, socioeconomic status, political views, and much more. For some, the main benefit of this increased cultural knowledge will be self-awareness. For others, the main benefit will be learning about others and how they see the world and experience the world that may be different from them. But for everyone, though, the goal can be similar, and that's to learn what is needed to reduce the frequency of unintentional cultural offenses that hinder and damage healthy interactions at home with family and friends, especially at work with colleagues and those whom you serve and support, and in a community at large. Now, I understand that many of you listening to this may be thinking that this is a pointless effort. It seems too risky of a goal to even try, or simply an impossible one. And in many ways, it makes sense. Because one of the most common reasons people have for avoiding interactions with people from different cultural backgrounds is not cultural hatred, but instead it's the fear that their lack of sufficient cultural knowledge or expertise could lead to unintentional cultural offenses. Simply put, many conclude that because they don't know enough about others and others must know more than they do, it's best if they say nothing and leave those conversations addressing different cultural needs to the experts. The problem with that mindset, though, is since so many people feel this way, few conversations occur, and thus legitimate needs go unmet. I don't believe this has to be the case. Without knowing everything about everyone, you can contribute to conversations addressing cultural needs around you while reducing the risk of these unintentional cultural offenses. That's why I want to offer something a little bit different than the usual. I hope that this podcast can offer a shame and guilt-free encouragement in your personal and professional efforts to interact with and serve everyone you encounter without fear, no matter your cultural similarities or differences. I want to help you address the many seemingly deep topics in a practical and usable way. Not only that, but I want to do it in a way that isn't one-sided. The goal is for everyone, on no matter what side you're on, to be seen and heard and understood, no matter your similarities or differences. As a therapist, I get to specialize in helping strengthen relationships between people who feel as though they're on opposite sides of the world, let alone the same important topic. And while this began with an emphasis on intimate relationships, it became clear to me that the same relationship skills that have helped bridge divides and mend seemingly irreconcilable relationship differences in the home were also beneficial outside of the home in strengthening seemingly irreconcilable cultural differences in a variety of environments. That's why, no matter who you are, where you come from, where you live, or who you interact with on a daily basis, this podcast can be for you. See, this podcast is for you if you're in a family where one or more of your close friends or extended family members, close family members has married someone, is close friends with someone from a different cultural background, political affiliation, or many other differences, and you're struggling with how to communicate and connect with them in light of these differences between you. Or maybe you're a medical professional interested in improving your bedside manner, avoiding communication barriers that can limit treatment effectiveness. Maybe you're an educator or administrator desiring to help teachers and students feel respected and understood in consideration of their cultural differences and uniquenesses rather than in spite of them. Maybe you're a business leader motivated to reach out to new and existing clients in ways to help them feel like valued customers, valued employees, making efforts to learn about their needs and meeting a greater variety of needs in the community. Or you're in an organization where you want those in leadership to help you feel seen, heard, and understood, and don't feel as though you're getting that now. Or maybe you're a religious leader hoping to convey a genuine desire to understand and accept people's differences while making efforts to meet their spiritual and emotional needs in the process. Maybe you're even a political leader, a community leader, faced with adjusting to changing demographics and with limited experience and expertise while having a sincere motivation to help create healthy community interactions and bring about positive change. And maybe sometimes you might be a law enforcement or a professional seeking to not only improve public perceptions and efforts, but also to cultivate genuine positive interactions, make healthy and effective decisions in, for your own safety, as well as the safety and well-being of the communities who you're hoping to genuinely protect and serve. Basically, this podcast is for anyone who wants to confront fear and discomfort stemming from lack of knowledge and learn how to effectively interact with everyone, no matter your similarities or differences. As I mentioned previously, diversity has often been associated with negative experiences, and this is often the case because many people have had experiences that have conveyed the message that who they are and the ways in which they may be different from those around them was a problem. And while life would feel a lot easier if everyone were the same, less things to learn and adjust to, it is our differences that make life interesting. And while change is admittedly inconvenient at times, some changes are worth it, not just for the benefit of others, but in enhancing your quality of life as well. One thing we all have in common, no matter our differences, is that we all want to be accepted for who we are. It's just that some have felt more accepted than others, and there's a greater need to help broaden that experience. As a result, instead of trying to figure out who the best person is and making everyone else conform to that person or group of people, we can learn how to understand as much as we can about as many people as possible and learn to appreciate the benefit of our differences rather than resenting and being inconvenienced by our differences, and hopefully feel accepted for who we are in the process. It doesn't happen overnight, but you can make a difference where you are, strengthening one relationship at a time. You can be a part of mending broken relationships, pleasantly surprising people in your personal life and in your workplace who fear tense interactions because of perceived cultural differences, and hopefully prevent negative interactions from even occurring. If that interests you, first, thank you in advance for being open and interested to having the best possible interactions with everyone you encounter. And I also encourage you to consider subscribing to the podcast, returning to tune in to upcoming messages where I offer some practical and encouraging answers to frequently asked multicultural awareness and diversity questions, designed specifically to help you improve your personal and professional relationships, no matter your cultural similarities and differences. Meantime, thanks for listening in today to the Diversity Dude podcast. And if there are any pressing diversity-related questions that you'd like me to address on an upcoming podcast, or if you're in need of shame-free or empowering guest speaking or training that's often more positive on this sensitive topic, then feel free to reach out to me directly. Or you can reach me at www.lambersfisher.com. Now, I hope to address as many topics as possible to help you improve as many relationships as possible. And as I close, remember this. You don't need to know everything about everyone in order to take steps in having a positive impact on someone. Thanks for tuning in and have a great day.
Tune in each week and find out how to demand and implement diversity at your job. To hear more, check out previous Diversity Dude shows on ShalettaMakesMeLaugh.com.
Children's Minnesota, the leader in specialized healthcare for kids, is here to raise awareness, standards, the bar, the stakes, the question, the curtain. On raising kids' health to the highest priority, kids need equal access to healthcare, more pediatric expertise, a voice for change. Kids need us, all of us. So let's raise them up. Children's Minnesota, the kid experts.
OutSchool provides live online classes for kids. They offer academic classes as well as interest-based classes. The topics are so cool. Everything from art and fitness to physics, mindfulness, food, history. A lot of these topics are things that are not taught in your regular school. Check out their amazing classes. Your kids are gonna love it.
I love mealtime with my family, especially when my mom lets us help with cooking. We always have a good time mixing eggs and cutting the crust off bread for sandwiches. But I had no idea that eggshells and breadcrumbs could be recycled. Do you know that 20% of trash is food waste? But there is something we can do to get that number down. Ramsey County has a program that lets us recycle food. That's right. I gather up banana peels, orange peels, and meat scraps that I can find. Then once a week, I drop them off at Ramsey County's food scrap collection site, where it gets turned into compost for gardening, landscaping, and more. It doesn't cost my mom a dime, and I feel like I'm doing my part to save the planet. Recycling is for everyone, and it's easy to do. Just log on to RamseyRecycles.com to find out more.
For millions of Americans, the pandemic impacted our financial situations, and a lot of people lost their jobs. But that should not mean you have to lose your house if you can't pay for your mortgage. Listen, no need to feel ashamed if you missed a payment or two or three, because there's a local organization that's willing to help you get caught up on those payments so you can keep your home. Let me tell you about the Minnesota Home Ownership Center. It's a nonprofit whose sole purpose is to prevent you from going into foreclosure. The Minnesota Home Ownership Center has a network of organizations around the state to review everything with you, explain your options, and then advocate for you to get the help you need. And get this, they won't charge you because it's all free. Check out hocmn.org or give them a call at 651 410-1086 to set up an appointment. You worked hard to get into that house. Let Minnesota Homeownership Center help you stay in it.
All right, did you know I was the Mommy Slam Dunk Champion?
Really?
Yes, really. Don't sound so surprised.
Let's see it.
Oh, you're ready. All right, here we go. Let's hear the crowd. So go to right, go to left. Fake a mom. Mama, go. Oh, Mama!
She did it.
Again?
You can't avoid gravity, but United Healthcare can help you avoid financial surprises by helping you compare costs and doctor quality ratings. United Healthcare.
Uh-huh.